Hi everyone, I'm Mr. Mizrahi, and today we're going to talk about...
When we multiply numbers that are greater than 10, it's very important to show students that there is a more than just one way to do it. So traditionally, if we take, for example, if we have 12 times 4, and we take the 12, which is the greater factor, we write it above it, or the 4. So then we have 12, and then under it we have the 4. And that's how we start multiplying. We multiply 4 by 2 and then 4 by 1, that's how we get 48. But according to the area model, students get to see the value of 12 and how the 4 as a factor that is multiplied by each one of them plays out. What do I mean by that? If you take a rectangle and you draw a rectangle and you divide it into two parts, because 12 has two numbers in it, it has 10 and 2. So you divide it into two parts. On top of each part, you write 10 and then 2. And this is how the students can see that you're actually multiplying 10 by 4 and not just 4 by 1. So here is 10 times 4, that is 40. That makes more sense than just 4 times 1. And 2 times 4 is 8. In this way, students get to multiply each digit in the number based on its value, not just by the number. As opposed to the traditional way where we have 4 times 2 is 8, and then we do 4, and then the students say 4 times 1. But this is not 1, this is 10. And we know that this, the answer is 48.